Hello, world. So, rumor has it that some unnamed internal project in a not-to-be-named company thinks that the best way to describe EGF form UI is as metatables in an RDBMS relational database, edited to change definitions with some archaic GUI, and then write a complicated runtime interpreter of database rows in JavaScripts. Of course, that's possible. But experience shows that code generation using simple, straightforward templates is often easier and more maintainable than smart interpreters. In 2015, there are great tools for doing something like this. For example, the eSIN subproject of the modeling framework EMF at eclipse.org. Let's try this out and see how easy it is actually to do something like this. What we're looking at here is a meta model. For modeling something like a form UI. This is written in Xcore, a language of EMF that allows you to define classes such as form, having attributes such as name, title label, containing fields, such as this one here, fields, having names, labels, maybe some binding to some model, a type, such as a text, email, number. Maybe a required flag. What we can do is generate code from this. This happens automatically to get some Java beans representing this model. In this case, this shows up here, and you get these different types. It then becomes very easy to write a template that is strongly typed, very productive to write. In this case here, we've written a form HTML generator using Extend's template language support. So this receives a form, then writes out an HTML header, then writes out an HNAME with the form's name. We can get everything we have available here like this and see the form's title label or the form's name or any of the other attributes if we had any more here. We can then open, let's say, an unordered list of list items or field labels, just as an example. With no other code than just this new Xcore class and this one very simple template, we could even write an integration test, such as the code down here, that loads an instance of this, runs the generator, and asserts that it is the same as an expected HTML file. To try this out, what we do is switch over to this hosted Eclipse instance here, and we can see how very easy it is to create instances describing one specific model of such a form. For example, this form one here. This form one has the name form one and the title label contact generated. It's got a number of fields, which we see here. For example, the name field, the email address field, the phone field, the age field. These are editable right in here in source or in here in this editor. This generic eSIN editor takes 0 lines of code because it's automatically available from eSIN. The generator that we saw earlier then can generate HTML code. Let me delete this. If we make some change here, name, and save this file, we get an HTML down here, which, as you remember from our template, the header, and here the different fields and the name of the form. It would be trivial to change this template to look more like our initial example and have this look and feel if we just adapted the very easy template. It would be equally trivial to add some additional attributes to this model here. And which automatically regenerates the Java beans that can be used immediately in the template and tested by creating new instances or better real tests to generate whether it's a UI form or any other code generation. Thanks to eSIN, this is very easy and takes less time than development of dedicated editors or specific grammars perhaps with other frameworks. Thanks for watching.